Hi, good morning. Myself Dr. Vivekanshu. Today we will discuss on Indian Society of Toxicology YouTube session on one of the toxic riddles and try to analyze it for understanding the clinical toxicology. So it is the first 132nd toxic riddle in rhymes during terror of corona times by toxic detective for solving crimes. On Indian Society of Toxicology's paradigms. So the riddle goes like this. It is a toxic riddle by detective in rhymes. On Krishna's birth, darkness goes, reducing terror of the corona times. I do relieve sore throat and low dose, but do harm to list her source in high. Am I cheap, stripper, Joseph chose, charge no fee, no all, it's a lie. I first met Ferdinand to get close. Ben's car ball leaked too, but why? Causing life of boy at risk to lose. He intoxicated in Goa's fanny dry. Driving to kill self, he didn't slows. He got injured in kidneys to sigh. Rabbit syndrome, tremor in flow. Hydrocute known to leaf die. Breath was acidotic, shallow and slow. Met him globin harm to guy. Me thylene blue cure you know. My toxic harm to charming smile rye. Ventilator support dialysis to throw. He ate cherry brownie, ask a PM pro. Micro B side around hospital die. Guessing call Terry, Ben cosmetic glow. So this is the complete riddle and it covers the whole screen page. Now, can you guess it, what it can be? Yes, you are right. The answer is phenol toxicity. So we'll discuss step by step about the history, the myths and mythology, the commercial uses, biochemistry and pharmacology, clinical features, medico-legal issues, first aid and antidotes, postmortem, and toxic histopathology. And we'll discuss each stranger wise about the toxic riddle and discuss these findings in this. Right? So coming to first stranger, the history, myths and mythology. So phenol is a dark brown liquid, disinfectant. The master key, it was considered the master key to all the infectious problems, right? And the mythology says, on Krishna's birth, darkness goes, reducing terror of the corona times. We are praying to Lord Krishna to get us all safely out of the corona times. We want to save ourselves. So we pray to Lord Krishna. Recently, there was Krishna Janmashtami, we celebrated all. So on that occasion, we compiled this riddle. So Krishna name literally means the dark, as he was born in new moon night and he was born from the best blessings of the goddess Kali to slain the enemy, his uncle Kans, the Kauravs, who did a lot of wrong things. So that was the purpose of his birth on the earth, right? So Lord Krishna, he is worshipped as a dark lord and he is the master key to all our problems. That is, he can sort out with prayers, we can get away with all the problems. Similarly, the master key, we know, the phenol, it is also said to be the master key to the organic chemistry. So how it can be? The phenol chemical structure and function simulate, look alike, act alike the master key. If we want to read the organic chemistry, if you master the subject of phenol, then you are all through it, because it is a basic structure, basic aromatic benzene ring which defines it. So Ben's car ball leaked too, but why? So Ben's stands for the benzene and carbolic, it is the homophonic word. So phenols are organic compounds which contain a hydroxyl group attached to carbon atom in a benzene ring. We can see the phenol dynamics, the 3D image of phenol and the chemical structure. How beautiful it looks like. An image of neutral phenol substructure, you can see that what are the different aspects of electrostatic, like the green, which is the neutral one, the orange red, it is the electronegative area, and the blue is the electropositive phenolic proton, right? So it acts chemically in further commercial uses. So I first met Ferdinand to get close. Now phenol was discovered in 1834 by Ferdinand, who extracted it from coal tar. Then phenol was introduced as disinfectant by Lemare in the 19th century, and it quickly became popular ever since Joseph Lister advocated its use in surgery for asepsis. Today, safer alternatives, which are non-carcinogenic, like ceramide, chlorhexidine, chlorzalinol, terpenol, are preferred. Microbicide all around hospital dye. So it is microbicidal, that is, it is homophonic words. Phenol was once widely used as an antiseptic. Its use pioneered by Joseph Lister, as phenol derivatives Cresol, Lysol can be used in phenol formaldehyde resins. Am I cheap stripper? Joseph chose. So Joseph is the Joseph Lister, and it is inexpensive and cheap because it is generated from coal tar and it attracted many small scale uses all over the world. So phenol was a component of industrial paint stripper used in the aviation industry for the removal of epoxy, polyurethane and other chemically resistant coatings. Like, we can trace out the cracks in the Boeing wings by use of the paint stripper, that is a phenol is applied so that the paint can be removed and we can see the underlying cracks in the aluminum body in the aircraft inspection. So it is routinely done still now. Similarly, Lord Krishna, he strips out all the problems and hurdles. So phenol is very unique molecule that is relatively small and capable of forming exceptionally strong hydrogen bonds with the coating, making it a powerful penetrant. Phenol strips out all problematic microbes in our hospital and homes. That was the commercial uses of it. So it charges no fee, no all, it's a lie. So fee, no all, it's phenol, the homophonic word. And phenol and its derivatives were used in past, like the Dettol, it contained the phenol. Then industrial solvents, the caustic, the paint stripper, the disinfectants, the germicides, it was rampantly used in every hospital and every nursing home. Even our homes were getting cleaned with phenol, right? And in rainy season, it is popular as a snake repellent in rainy season. The cords of the thread, they are soaked in phenol and they are put on the rat holes to get away the snake, because the snake hates smell and it is corrosive. It is locally corrosive and it is systemically intoxicant. So since snake is a vertebrate, so he suffers the toxicity and he avoids it. So it is used as a snake repellent in rainy season, the phenol. Causing life of boy at risk to lose. So life of boy is life boy. Life boy was the first famous brand of UK. It became a famous brand of carbolic soap kept in all the Indian government hospitals, surgical OTs for hand washing, scrubbing and disinfecting till 2005. We could smell the carbolic smell when we entered the OT. From the early 1900s, phenol was used in production of carbolic soap. Now, today's Lifebuoy does not contain phenol. I do relieve sore throat in low dose. So phenol spray, usually at 1.4% phenol, very diluted. It is used as an active ingredient used medically in sore throat. In relieving the sore throat, it was prescribed. So sore throat is one of the first symptoms of COVID illness. So we are going through the corona times. And there are a lot of alternatives which came for curing the sore throat, like herbal teas, the remedies for this. So these all can be harmful. We have to be careful. Even herbal teas, they were toxic. Similarly, the phenol, it's toxic. Guessing coal tarry ban cosmetic glow. So coal tarry, coal tar, it is a homophonic word because carbolic acid is derived from coal tar. An association between occupational exposure of chlorophenol with nasal and oropharyngeal cancer has been observed in a study done in 2000. And thus banning the hospital use of phenol and its derivatives empirically for medicinal purposes. So it was a large study which was done, which established that it can cause cancers. But do harm to list her source and high. So Lister is the Lister, the Joseph Lister, who discovered the use, antiseptic use, and it is a corrosive poison. So it caused sores on the skin, in the throat. So corrosive poisons were formerly common suicidal agents, though they are now relatively rare in the West, probably because the ease of obtaining less painful substances. So corrosives, mostly the sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, they were consumed because they were used as in the household. But the unique feature about phenol is it's cheap. It is painless because it causes local anesthetic effect. So the person who consumes it does not feel so much pain. That's why it is preferred as a suicidal agent, and it is rapidly fatal because it is not just locally corrosive, it is systemically, it is intoxicating, causing comatose state, thus rapid death, unlike sulfuric acid, which causes just the local corrosive burns and perforation. Accidentally, it can be ingested by children as it looks like cola color, and it can be absorbed through the skin also on application. And homicidal, very rare, adds repulsive smell, the carbolic smell, it is astringent smell and burning taste, so it can't be used for homicidal purposes. So what is carbolic toxidrome? It is locally corrosive and systemically it causes sympatholytic and cholinergic effects. So how it presents? Locally, the skin effects are in pure form, damage to the nerve endings, causes initial tingling sensation, later numbness, coagulation necrosis, break of the intercellular linkage, and further deeper penetration of the acid, causing painless white opaque char and necrosis and gangrene of the tissue with grayish white sloughing. This is very nicely described by Dr. Nageshwar Rao in his book in FMT, the local effects as well as the systemic effects. In the GIT, it initially causes burning sensation, tingling sensation, and anesthesia. So vomiting is seen very rarely on consuming dilute solutions of phenol, unlike other corrosives, which causes persistent vomiting due to the irritant effect. But since it is having a local anesthetic effect, so vomiting is very rare presentation. That's why aspiration pneumonia is less common compared to the other inorganic acids. It is an organic acid, so it is more causes respiratory tract effects, inhalation of phenolic vapors because it is aromatic. So inhalation can cause phenolic vapors and that can cause pneumonitis, laryngeal and pulmonary edema, it starts breathing and cyanosis. And again the methemoglobin which is generated also causes the breathing difficulty. And the CNS and CAB effects, phenol is a fat soluble, hence it attacks on the nervous system tissues, it causes paralysis of the respiratory and cardiovascular centers and ultimately causing death by the sympatholytic effect. So, breath was acidotic, shallow and slow, that is what we discussed about the respiratory depression and methemoglobin harm to guy. So, methemoglobin is generated by carbolic acid. So, the antidote is required to be given, right? He got injured in kidneys to sigh. Now, it typically causes acute glomerulonephritis with oliguria, albuminuria, cast anuria and renal failure and carbolinuria also. And when we go for the histopathological examination, flea-bitten kidney can be found as in other corrosive poisons because it is submucosal hemorrhagic lesions which occurs in the kidney cortex due to the corrosive effect of phenol and its metabolites. Ventilator support dialysis to throw. So ventilator support is required due to the comatose state to support the breathing and dialysis is required to throw out the toxin phenol and its metabolite out of the body because they are systemically sympatholytic and cholinergic action occurs. He intoxicated and Goa's fanny dry. So you can see dry phenol, it is alcohol which looks like it is a toxic acid which acts like an alcohol because it is intoxicating. So it looks like a dry alcohol. If it is consumed, then it can cause corrosive effect locally and systemically, the intoxicating effects. So historically, the benzene ring was given a name of fenny as the chemical name for all the compounds derived from the benzene rings, and the phenol was the basic. So consequently, when the aromatic ring was attached to something, it was called phenyl or phenyl. So phenyl became the brand name for household cleaners and disinfectant containing phenol as its corrosive and it is used to kill microbes, thus cleaning the tile stains. So, driving to kill self, he didn't slow. Feni. Feni is the phenol. And Feni is also the Goan Feni, which is alcohol brewed. So it is metaphoric use of this word Feni we have done. It is intoxicating sedative effect which caused by the phenol. And although it is not roadside trauma which occurs with phenol consumption, but it do cause in suicidal attempts. Person goes into a comatose state and he drives fast, didn't slow. That is, the comatose state progresses fast if he has consumed the fatal dose into permanent damage and causing hypoxic brain damage to the vital organs, killing the individual. Hydroquinone, known to leaf dye. So this is one of the typical features which we can see. The hydroquinone is a metabolite of carbolic acid and it is leafy green color which causes carboluria. And this whole picture is known as exogenous ochronosis. Although ochronosis is mostly genetic, it occurs due to genetic mutation. But exogenous, externally you are giving some substance which causes cutaneous disorder characterized by blue-black pigmentation resulting as a complication of long-term application of skin lightening creams containing hydroquinone, but may also occur due to topical application with phenol or resorquinol in dark-skinned individuals. So this can cause a typical clinical syndrome on chronic application. So this is methylene blue cured. You know why? So methylene blue is the antidote for binding out the methemoglobin which is causing the hypoxia. So thylene, it is chronic malnutrition. So it causes phenol, typically causes phenol marasmus in occupational exposure. So the people who are working in the industry, healthcare settings, they get malaise, fatigue and hepatitis. And this was classically described as phenol marasmus. Today's phenol exposures are more likely to result in dermal exposures following the spills. So what does phenol marasmus look like? A person who is having ochronosis, his eyelids, it looks like a green mascara has been applied on the sclera as well as on the eyelids. That is a typical clinical picture which has been reported from Dr. V.V. Pillai's Comprehensive Medical Toxicology. A typical toxidrome you can identify in people who are working with chronic use of phenol. It was seen in the past and it gives a charming look to the person without applying any mascara. But it shows that the person is getting sick due to the phenol marasmus. So it is a wry smile. It's smile wry. So that is what we are describing about the phenol marasmus in this toxic riddle. And the rabbit syndrome, tremor in flow. So rabbit syndrome, the rabbit moves. This is the rabbit movement. You can see the rhythmic motions of mouth along the vertical plane without involvement of the tongue. So it is typically seen when the person consumes phenol or any antipsychotic medications. These are the extrapyramidal effects of its toxicity. So this is classically described in recent edition of Modi's Medical Jurisprudence Toxicology. And this has been reported in few cases, like one in Japan, in which an elderly female attempted suicide by phenol and she went into respiratory arrest and deep coma. She was resuscitated. And then when she was revived, she showed rhythmic perioral movements with Parkinsonian findings. So when further evaluation was done, she was prescribed neuroleptic drugs. Phenol intoxication may cause the rabbit syndrome by inducing cholinergic dominance. The abnormal movements were aggregated by administration of neuroleptic and ameliorated by discontinuation of the drug. They disappeared completely by the hospital stay, day 15. So how did it occur? The rabbit syndrome is due to the inducing the cholinergic dominance with relative dopamine hypofunction in the central nervous system, the sympatholytic effect of phenol toxicity. So now coming to the postmortem findings, phenol, cresol and lysol, they're the phenyls, the carbolic acid, which is pure phenol, it tends to stiffen the tissues and bleaches them so that hard, cracked, whitish surfaces are seen on the face and skin. Similar findings are seen in internal organs when postmortem is done. So lysol is similar like phenol. It is corrosive locally and systemically it is intoxicating, but it gives brownish purple lesions. So typical case has been described by Bernard Knight in forensic pathology book, in which you can see the dribbling lesions and trickling marks Now, these are typical features which are seen in corrosive acid ingestion. If the person ingests suicidally, so he is continuously ingesting. If it is forceful, he will try to withdraw himself and he will not swallow so much. But if a person is swallowing in standing or sitting erect while drinking the liquid, then it causes the dribbling marks, the lesions which are typical in corrosive poison seen. When postmortem is done, opening the stomach, we can see he ate cherry brownie, ask a PM Pro. So a postmortem professional, we call it pro. So a postmortem professional, when opens it up, he can smell the typical phenolic hospital-like odor on opening up the stomach. And the lesions which are seen are brown black discolored lesions, like the person has eaten a brownie with cherry in it, the reddish lesions, which are the hemorrhagic lesions due to the local corrosive effect, and the thick hardened mucosa which occurs. So they give a look of cherry brownie. Now, what are the medical legal issues related to carbolic acid poisoning? It is considered as a dangerous weapon or means. So it is a typical ideal example of a dangerous means by which it has been defined pran ghatak under section 324 and 326 of IPC, because it is by means of poison or any corrosive substance. The person goes into deleterious by human body, either to inhale or ingestion, it causes these symptoms. So it is typically described. Now, when we go for opining about the cause of death, what we will classify, whether it is toxic or the corrosive, because it is locally corrosive and systemically toxic. So the death occurs by what? Because phenolic corrosives, however, such as carbolic acid and lysol, are ideal example of corrosive poison. Corrosive is shaker, shar, it is the Hindi meaning, and zeher, vish. So toxicology, none of these presents much problem, as the damage is often structural rather than poisonous, unless the victim survives long enough to have complications such as renal failure or chest infection. So the person dies due to the systemic effect, so it is a toxic cause. Corrosive effect is only locally, that will not cause the death. It is the immediate intoxicating effect of phenol that causes the death of the person who has ingested the fatal dose. So the take home message is that phenol, the answer of a riddle, it says that proper handling is required of the hazardous chemicals like phenol by using personal protective equipment. We are all aware now in the corona times about what are PPEs. So wearing the apron, gloves, eye shield, goggles to prevent occupational exposure or inadvertent toxicity of phenol, even if you are doing experiment in your biochemistry class or in your chemistry lectures. So if you are in the experimental lab, then you should take precaution while handling phenol. Thank you.